Dear students, welcome to my classroom. In previous part of the chapter, pair of linear equations in two variables, you are introduced about algebraic methods, that is substitute method and elimination method, to find the solutions of pair of linear equations in two variables. And also we solved some problems in exercise 4.2, which are based on algebraic methods. And in this class, we are going to solve remaining chapters of that class, that exercise. So let's start with the fifth problem. A fraction will be equal to 4/5 if one is added to both numerator and denominator. If, however, 5 is subtracted from both numerator and denominator, the fraction will be equal to 1/2. What is the fraction? That is the question. Okay, here we have a fraction and we don't know the numerator and denominator of the fraction. And it is given that if 1 is added to both numerator and denominator, the fraction will be equal to 4/5. And also it is given that if 5 is subtracted from both numerator and denominator, the fraction will be equal to 1/2. And we need to find the fraction. So, as we don't know the numerator and denominator of the given fraction, let the numerator of the fraction be x and the denominator of the fraction be y. Then the fraction is x by y. Okay. Now, according to the problem, what is given? If 1 is added to both numerator and denominator, the fraction is equal to 4/5. That is, x plus 1 by y plus 1 is equal to 4/5. Isn't it? When we are adding 1 to both numerator and denominator, the fraction will be equal to 4/5. So we can express that sentence as the equation x plus 1 by y plus 1 is equal to 4/5. And let us make a linear equation of two variables using this equation. So, from this equation, we can write 5 into x plus 1 is equal to 4 into y plus 1. By cross multiplication, we are writing this. And by simplifying it, we get 5x plus 5 is equal to 4y plus 4. And after that, 5x minus 4y is equal to 4 minus 5. And we can write it as 5x minus 4y equal to minus 1. Take it as equation 1. And according to second hint, what is given? If 5 is subtracted from both numerator and denominator, then the fraction will be equal to 1/2. Okay, so let us write the equation for the sentence. What can we write? X minus 5 by y minus 5 is equal to 1/2. That is, we are subtracting 5 from both the numerator and denominator, and the fraction will be equal to 1/2. So we can write it as x minus 5 by y minus 5 is equal to 1/2. And from that, by cross multiplication, we can write 2 into x minus 5 is equal to 1 into y minus 5. So by simplifying it, we get 2x minus 10 is equal to y minus 5. And from that, we can write 2x minus y is equal to minus 5 plus 10, which is equal to 5. So the equation is 2x minus y is equal to 5. Take it as equation 2. So now we can solve the equation 1 and 2 in elimination method. So while solving the equations in elimination method, we make the coefficients of either x or y equal. So here I am multiplying equation 1 by 2 and multiplying equation 2 by 5. So equation 1 into 2 implies 2 5s are 10x minus 2 4s are 8y is equal to 2 minus 1s are minus 2. So that is 10x minus 8y is equal to minus 2. And also multiplying equation 2 by 5. Equation 2 into 5, what we get? 5 into 2x is 10x. Minus 5 into y is 5y is equal to 5 5 is a 25. Now let us subtract these two equations, because here both the signs of x in both the equations are same, positive. So that's why we have to subtract these equations. So by subtracting, while subtracting, we have to change the signs in second equation. Now 10 minus 10x will be cancelled, and minus 8y plus 5y is equal to minus 3y. Minus 2 minus 25 is minus 27, and from this we can write y is equal to minus 27 by minus 3, and which is equal to 9. Now substituting this value in equation 2, what we get? Substituting this value in equation 2, we get 2 into x minus y is equal to 5, and we have the value of y as 9. So 2x minus 9 is equal to 5, and from this we can write 2x is equal to 5 plus 9, which is equal to 14. So x is equal to 14 by 2 and is equal to 7. Now we got the values of x as 7 and value of y as 9. So our required fraction is 7 by 9. Okay. We assume that our fraction is x by y. So the required fraction is x by y, which is equal to 7 by 9. And now take the sixth problem. Places A and B are 100 km apart on a highway. One car starts from A and another from B at the same time at different speeds. If the cars travel in the same direction, they meet in 5 hours. If they travel towards each other, they meet in 1 hour. What are the speeds of the two cars? So, observe the question carefully. So two cars are at places A and B, which are apart from 100 km on a highway, and one car starts from A and another starts from B with different speeds. If the cars travel in the same direction, they will meet in 5 hours, and if they travel towards each other, that is in opposite direction, they will meet in 1 hour. And we need to find the speeds of the two cars. Okay, so let us see the scenario with a figure. So this is the highway, and on this highway we have two places A and B, which are 100 kilometers away, and on this highway we have two cars at A and B, and these two cars are moving the same direction with different speeds like this. So you can observe the two cars are traveling in the same direction, and after 5 hours they meet each other. So to meet each other, the cars taken 5 hours. So cars take 5 hours to meet. When two cars are traveling in same direction, they take 5 hours to meet, and in this case, in the second case, they are traveling in say opposite direction, that is towards each other, like this. So in this case, they take 1 hour to meet. Cars take 1 hour to meet. Okay. So this is the scenario, and we need to find the speeds of the two cars. Okay. So let the speed of the car which started from the place A is x kilometer per hour, and the speed of the car which started from the place B is 5 km per hour. Now, in case 1, distance travelled by first car in 5 hours is 5 into x kilometer, because we know that the distance is equal to speed into time. Speed into time. The speed of the car is x kilometer per hour and the time travelled by car is 5 hours. So, the distance is time into speed. Time is 5 hours and speed is x kilometer. Speed is x kilometer per hour. So, the distance travelled by first car is 5 into x. That is 5x kilometer. And similarly, distance travelled by second car in 5 hours is 5y kilometer. Why we are taking 5 hours here? They meet after 5 hours. So, let us find the distances travelled by them. Now, here in first figure, you can observe that distance travelled by first car is 5x and the distance travelled by second car is 5y, and the difference between 5x and 5y is 100 kilometer. Okay, so here the according to problem, what we can write? The differences between the distances is equal to 100 kilometers. That is 5x minus 5y is equal to 100. And we can take 5 common on left side. So 5 into x minus y equal to 100. And from this, we are writing x minus y equal to 20. Take it as equation 1. And now, take case 2. In case 2, they travel for 1 hour towards each other. And after 1 hour, they meet each other. So, the distance travelled by first car in 1 hour is 1 into x, because the speed of the car is x kilometer per hour and the time is 1 hour. So, the distance travelled by first car in 1 hour is 1 into x kilometer, that is x kilometer. And similarly, distance travelled by second car in 1 hour is 1 into y, that is y kilometer. So, now take the look at the second picture. The distance travelled by first car is x kilometer, distance travelled by second car is y kilometer, and we can observe that the sum of x and y is equal to 100. Okay, so according to problem, we can write x plus y equal to 100. Take it as equation 2. So, let us solve these two equations. Solving equations 1 and 2. So, we in these two equations, we have the coefficients of x same. So, we can easily solve this in elimination method. So, x minus y equal to 20 is first equation and x plus y equal to 100 is second equation. So, let us solve these two equations in elimination method. While solving in elimination method, we have to change the signs in second equation. So, but here we no need to change the signs because we have the coefficients of y with different signs. So, we can directly cancel them. So, minus y plus y will be cancelled. Then x plus x 2x is equal to 20 plus 100, 120. So, from this we can write x equal to 120 by 2, which is equal to 60. So, we got the value of x. Now, substitute this value in equation 2. In equation 2, what we have, x plus y equal to 100. And now we are substituting x equal to 60. So, 60 plus y equal to 100. And y equal to 100 minus 60, y equal to 40. So, therefore, the speeds of the cars which are started from the points A and B are 60 km per hour and 40 km per hour respectively. Okay. So, this is the solution of the problem. Now, take the seventh one. Two angles are complementary. The larger angle is 3 degrees less than twice the measure of the smaller angle. Find the measure of each angle. So, very easy problem. So in given two supplementary angles, let the larger angle be x degrees and the smaller angle be y degrees. Now it is given that the two angles are supplementary. So then according to problem, the sum of two angles is 180. So x plus y equal to 180, take as equation 1. And also it is given that the larger angle x is 3 degrees less than twice the smaller angle y. That is x is equal to 2y minus 3, because x is 3 less than twice the smaller angle. So x is 2y minus 3. So take it as equation 2. Now in equation 2 we have directly x equal to 2y minus 3. So we can substitute x equal to 2y minus 3 in first equation. So we can solve these two equations in substitution method very easily. So substitute x equal to 2y minus 3 degrees in first equation. So substitute this value in equation 1. So what we have in equation 1, x plus y equal to 180 degrees. Now substitute x equal to 2y minus 3 degrees in equation 1. So that we can write 2y minus 3 degrees plus y is equal to 180 degrees. Now 2y plus y is 3y is equal to 180 plus 3, 183. So that y equal to 183 by 3, which is equal to 61 degrees. So we got the value of y, and we can find the x by substituting this y in x equal to 2y minus 3. So x equal to y minus 3 degrees, and now substitute the value y equal to 61 in this equation. So x equal to 2 into 61 minus 3, that is 122 minus 3 degrees, which is equal to 119 degrees. So this is the solution of the problem. Very easy problem. And now take the eighth one. A dictionary has a total of 1382 pages. It is broken up into two parts. The second part of the book has 64 pages more than the first part. How many pages are in each part of the book? That is the question. So here the book was broken into two parts. The second part of the book has 64 pages more than the first part. And we need to find the number of pages of each part of the book. So let the number of pages in the first part of the book be x, and the number of pages in second part of the book be y. Now according to problem, the sum of the pages in these two books is equal to 1382. So that we can write x plus y equal to 1382, which can be taken as first equation. And now in the second hint, what is given? The second part y has 64 pages more than first part x. That is, y is 64 more than x. That is, y equal to x plus 64. So whether we can write y equal to x plus 64. So we can take this one as equation 2. And in second equation, we have directly y equal to x plus 64. That is, one variable is expressed in terms of other variable. So we can write y equal to x plus 64 in first equation. So substitute this value in equation 1. X plus 64 is equal to 1382. So now 2x is equal to 1382 minus 64, and from that we can write 2x equal to 1318, and x equal to 1318 by 2, which is equal to 659. And now by substituting this x equal to 659 in y equal to x plus 64, that is in equation 2, we directly obtain the value of y. So now y equal to x plus 64. So write, substitute x equal to 659. So y equal to 659 plus 64. That is 723. Therefore, the values x equal to 659, y equal to 723. Therefore, the number of pages in first and second part of the books are 659 and 723 respectively. We can check here whether 659 plus 723 is equal to 1382 or not. And after that, whether second part has 64 pages more than the first part or not. Okay, by checking them we can find that our answer is correct. Now take the ninth problem. So if we multiply the first equation by 5, then we get 5x plus 5y equal to 500. So no need to multiply the second equation by any number. Okay, so equation 1 into 5 implies 5x plus 5y is equal to 500, and the second equation is 5x plus 6y equal to 5x plus 8y equal to 680. So here the coefficients of x are same in sign, so let us subtract them and let us change the signs in second equation. And now 5x minus 5x will be cancelled. Now 5y minus 8y is minus 3y is equal to minus 180. From this we can write y is equal to minus 180 by minus 3 and y is equal to 60. So we got the value of y. Now substitute this value in equation 1. So x plus y equal to 100, that is the first equation, and we are substituting y equal to 60, so that x plus 60 equal to 100 and x equal to 100 minus 60, which is equal to 40. So the quantity of first solution is 40 milliliters and the quantity of second solution is 60 milliliters. Okay. Now take the 10th one. You have 12,000 rupees saved amount and wants to invest it in two schemes yielding 10% and 15% interest. How much amount should be invested in each scheme so that you should get overall 12% interest? That is the question. So you have to split the amount 12% into two parts, such that one part should be invested in the scheme of 10% interest and second part should be invested in the scheme of 15% interest, so that you get overall 12% interest on the sum 12,000. Okay, so let the amount to be invested at the rate of 10% be X rupees and the amount to be invested at the rate of 15% be Y rupees. Now the sum of these two parts X and Y is 12,000 rupees. So then according to problem, X plus Y equal to 12,000, equation 1. And now what is the second hint here? The 10% of X rupees and 15% of Y rupees together are equal to 12% of 12,000 rupees. Okay, so we have here 10% of X rupees plus 15% of Y rupees is equal to 12% interest on 12,000 rupees. So now 10% of X plus 15% of Y equal to 12% of 12,000, and 10% of X is 10 by 100 into X, 15% of Y is 15 by 100 into Y, 12% of 12,000 is 12 by 100 into 12,000. Now let us simplify the fractions. 10 by 100 is 1 by 10, 15 by 100 is 3 by 20, and 12 by 100 into 12,000 is 1440. Now you can write this one as X by 10 plus 3 by 20 is equal to 1440, and can take the LCM in denominators. So the LCM is, LCM of 10 and 20 is 20, and 10 twos are 20, so that we have 2 into X is 2X. 20 ones are 20, so that 1 into 3Y is 3Y, and we have 2X plus 3Y by 20 equal to 1440. And from this we can write 2X plus 3Y equal to 20 into 1440 is 28,800. This is equation 2. And now we have both the equations, and let us solve these two equations in elimination method. So while solving in elimination method, we have to make the coefficients of X equal, and by multiplying the equation 2 by 2, we get 2x plus 2y equal to 24,000, and we get the coefficients of X equal. So equation 1 into 2 implies 2x plus 2y equal to 24,000, and equation 2 we have 2x plus 3y equal to 28,800. Now let us subtract these two equations. 2x minus 2x is cancelled. 2y minus 3y is equal to minus y, is equal to 24,000 minus 28,800 is equal to minus 4,800. So that we have minus y equal to minus 4,800. From this we can write y equal to 4,800. So we got the value of y. Now substitute this value in equation 1. We have the equation 1, x plus y equal to 12,000, and we are substituting y equal to 4,800 in that equation. That is x plus 4,800 equal to 12,000. And from this we can write x equal to 12,000 minus 4,800, which is equal to 7,200. Therefore, the amount to be invested at the rate of 10% is 7,200, and the amount to be invested at the rate of 15% is 4,800. Okay students, that's the end of exercise 4.2, and in next class we shall meet with a new concept, which are the equations reducible to linear equations. Until then, see you, bye.